Hi friends, welcome to EduTab. So welcome to the Everyday at 5 series brought to you by EduTab for IBPS AFO 2018-19. So this is lecture number 11 and it is Agricultural Engineering Part 3. So friends, what we have been doing is we have been taking some questions based on this particular chapter because many of our students have been requesting to discuss this particular chapter. So now we are in discussion, we are in the Part 3. So let us discuss the answers for the previous questions that we had put forth and next move on to next set of questions as well. So before that, the courses that EduTab has to offer for IBPS AFO 2018-19, we have a full video course which includes tests as well. Now, in this particular course, you would get concept videos, notes, MCQs, summary sheets, worksheets for each of the topics in agriculture. Plus, it also includes tests, which is 25 full-length tests and 25 sectional tests as well. Now, this course can be bought for ₹2499 and this particular price is valid only till tomorrow, that is 2nd of November 2018. Apart from that, we also have a separate test series which includes 25 full-length tests and 25 sectional tests along with detailed PDF solution. This particular course can be bought for ₹1499. So let us start with the discussion of the questions that we were putting forth yesterday. So the first one is, which of the following is an example of walking type tractor? Now the answer to this particular question is power tiller. Okay, so based on the type of construction that is there, the tractors can be divided into two. One is a conventional one where the driver takes a seat and is able to drive the tractor. The second one is that is called the walking type tractor. Okay, in this particular tractor, what happens is the operator actually just walks behind and operates it from behind. And there is no arrangement where the driver can actually sit. So this is called, that is why you can see from the name walking type tractor. Okay, now the answer being power tiller, it is in use these days. So this is becoming very popular. So we need to have a correct information about this type of equipment that is being used. Next, which was the first country to use power tiller on large scale? So Japan was the first country that actually came up with this use of power tillers. And the first time that the concept of power tiller was introduced, it was 1920. Okay, and in Japan, the full prototype, that is the complete construction and the usage of the power tiller for the first time was done in the year 1947. Okay, so the concept came in 1920 and the usage was in 1947. Now in India, this particular power tiller was used or came into existence in the year 1962-63, you can say. So if there is 63 in the option, you can choose this. Otherwise, if there's a range given, you can choose 1962-63, right? Okay, so this is a short background of the power tiller. So we have already seen all these points like the operator walks behind it. Okay, and it is also known as hand tractor. This is one important information. So we have seen that in the world, this particular concept came in 1920, Japan being the first country to use it on a large scale, right? In India, power tiller was introduced in the year 1963. Okay, and this is one other important point that we tend to neglect, but it is important that manufacturing of several makers of power tiller are like Iseki, Sato, Krishi, Kubota, Yanmar and Mitsubishi. Okay, so these were started in India after the year 1962. So there can also be a very simple question regarding the manufacturers of power tillers. So kindly make note of these names as well. Okay, here it is makers. Okay, just make this correction. Fine, the third one is, what is the depth of the cut which is made by a rotary plough? Right, now the answer to this particular question is 12 to 15 centimeter. Most of you have got it right. So you need to know the depth which the various implements make. Okay, this gives an idea regarding to what extent does it enters into the field and actually makes an effect in the entire tillage process. So whenever you're reading a particular implement, just try and find out if you can see an approximate depth range that is given for that particular tillage implement, right? Okay, so the next question, what is the field capacity of power harrow, which is tractor drawn? Okay, friends, so I have been seeing the comments which were given by many of our students in the comment section below. So most of them have mentioned it as 2.5 hectares per day. Okay, so I would just like to know the source from which you are mentioning this particular field capacity, because as per our understanding, the answer tends to be 1.5 hectare per day. But usually in these type of questions, there can be a discrepancy because there are different values also sometimes in different sources. Okay, so as per our understanding, it is 1.5 hectare per day, but I would like you all to mention the source so that we can cross check this once and come out with a correct answer next time if there is any change apart from 1.5 hectare per day. Okay, so this question, let us keep this open for discussion. Okay, so kindly mention it in the comment section below. Next one, okay, so now we're going to have a look at four questions. Now these questions, you all need to give me an answer by next session. We will discuss these the answers for these questions as well. Now friends, before I begin, I would just like to mention that what we'll do is in the coming lectures, we'll try and even go to the numerical part of it. Okay, it is not very certain that you will get a numerical, but there can be a probability. Even if you get one or two, then that also makes a lot of difference. Okay, so it is advisable that you know how these numericals are solved. These are very simple numericals where they deal only with the field capacity. Okay, the efficiency. Okay, so these are some of the parameters that they use, and then they ask questions based on it. So what we'll do is we'll simply solve some 2-3 MCQs based upon these numericals. So it will give you an understanding and you'll be able to easily solve the numericals if it appears in the paper. Okay, so today's first question for you guys, what is the working depth of a disc plow in millimeter? Okay, so as I had mentioned before, whenever you are studying a particular implement, it is important for us to know the working depth of it, right? So we have seen one of the working depths of rotary plow here in this particular session previously. Now here you need to tell me the working depth of a disc plow. Okay, so kindly choose from the options that you can see on your screens and mention the correct answer in the comment section below. Okay, so the second question, a very simple one, but still many of you might not be aware of it. So which of the following is also referred to as quack grass or Bermuda grass eradicator? You need to tell me the answer. It's going to be an interesting one because the options seem close, but kind of try to relate and try to understand what can be the probable answer, right? Okay, so the third question is, what is the capacity of rotavator in case if there is a power source of 35 to 65 horsepower? Okay, so you need to tell me the field capacity. Basically, the options are quite close, but you need to be very specific in these cases. Now, we were also discussing previously that rotavator is an implement which actually is used in the case of both primary as well as secondary tillage operations. So it becomes important for us. That's why we are going in detail of the various parameters of it. Okay, so the fourth question that we're going to discuss is, post hole digger is used for which of the following activities? Now, this is a tool which is used. Okay, so for what are we using this particular post hole digger? Are we using it for tree plantations? Are we using it for cereal crops? Is it only for spices or is it only for rice? You need to tell me the answer, kindly mentioned in the comment section below. So friends, this is a very nice way of learning because, you know, when you come across questions, your desire for learning gets increased. Okay, you become inquisitive and you try to search for answers. So in that process, you will also come across many other concepts that you don't know. So I would really appreciate if you make this series an interactive one. Kindly come up with the answers in the comment section below. So friends, if you have any query, you can drop us a mail at hello@edutab.co.in. You can also give us a call at 814-620-7241. So friends, with this we have come to the end of this lecture, which is part 3 of agricultural engineering, and I believe we can take up more such sessions on agricultural engineering. And please let me know if there's anything else which you want me to cover in the comment section below, so that accordingly I can plan the further lectures as well. You can also download the PDF of this particular lecture from EduTab's Telegram channel. The link for the channel is placed on your screens, and you can also find this link in the description box of this particular video. Now if you found this video useful, kindly like, subscribe and share. Till then friends, thank you so much and happy learning.